Dear brothers and sisters, hi, my name is George Tanos. I'm a chaplain, and I'm here to discuss with you today, what does the Bible say about divorce? Is divorce allowed as a Christian? Well, let's examine this real quick. In Matthew 19:16, God told us the following: so they are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let man not separate. And remember here, folks, many married couple out there, they say, well, that's my mother, well, that's my sister, that's my best friend. No. When you are married, you are one. You are no longer two. No one has the right to come and interfere in your married life except the both of you. Let's look again. What does God tell us about divorce? And this is back in the Old Testament during Moses' days. In Malachi 2:16, God says, I hate divorce, says the Lord God of Israel, and I hate a man's covering himself with violence as well as with his garment, says the Lord Almighty. So guard yourself and your spirit, and do not break faith. Here we go again. God tells us he hates divorce, so be careful. In Ephesians 25 through 33, let's see what God tells us here. He gives clear instructions to men. Husbands, love your wives just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. Make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, but holy and blameless. In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hated his own body, but he feeds and cares for it, just as Christ does the church. For we are members of his body. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. Here we go again, one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church. However, each one of you also must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband. So here we go again. God gives clear instructions. You become one, not two anymore. No one has the right to interfere in your marriage. But I tell you, this is in Matthew 5:32. But I tell you that anyone who divorces his wife, except for marital unfaithfulness, causes her to become an adulteress, and anyone who marries a divorced woman commits adultery. So here God tells us that the only way for divorce that would be acceptable is if one of you commits adultery. Now, let's go further a little bit here. If you are in an abusive relationship, leave. Bring this to your husband's attention and to the church. Inform your husband that you will not return until this changes. Both of you should be willing to commit yourselves to God. If your husband refuses, remain in prayers. Be still. Be patient. If you discover that your husband has committed adultery, then divorce. So here I'm talking to the, you know, mainly the females. If you're in an abusive relationship, you don't need to tolerate this. You know, if you are being beaten up, call the authority, file charges. No one has the right to abuse someone else. And leave that situation immediately. And pretty much that abusive husband, especially if he is not in Christ, he will seek other women out there. If you discover this, and you discover this man has committed adultery, even ask him, hey, have you slept with someone else? That's grounds for divorce by God's laws. And that's what we need to act upon. Then we file for divorce. And that's pretty much probably what will happen in many situations. Brothers and sisters, this is from postmyprayer.com. If you need a prayer, please come to us. Click on Request a Prayer, and we will bring it live and pray for you. So, and then also everyone can pray for you here. As you see here, we get people from all over the world that wants everyone to pray for one another. May the good Lord bless you and stay in faith. I am George Tanos, and I wish you the best in life. Thank you for watching.